Hey, my name is Pete Miser. I'm an independent hip-hop artist, and we are here at 94 Wythe, the home of Kinfolk and Kinfolk Studios. I've been involved in hip-hop for about 20 years now. Today, I'm going to introduce you to Quickstep and Rockefeller, a married couple. They're also involved in Full Circle, a nonprofit organization that educates kids through the use of hip-hop. And they are also the founders of a party called Behind the Groove, which is an old school throwback style party trying to keep the hip hop culture alive in New York City. Do you remember and can you describe the first time you ever encountered b-boying?
I have to say, first, it was around the way. I'm originally from East Harlem, El Barrio, 112th Street and 5th Avenue, Taft Projects. And my mom and I were just walking through the courtyard. Yeah, and there were people there with a boombox getting down. And I didn't know what I was looking at. My mother definitely didn't know what she was looking at. We were just walking past it. And they weren't really doing like anything that I know as breaking. It was just people together doing something together. And it wasn't until the movies came out that then I was like, that's what that is.
I remember this pool hall we used to go to. I saw somebody, I didn't know what it was, but I wanted to do it. I was like, what is that? He was doing what, you know, I later found out was called helicopters. So he was grooving on top and just went and started going to helicopters. And I saw it from out in the street in the pool hall, and I ran because I wanted to go see what it was, and my mom grabbed me by my shirt. No, tú no vas para allá. I was like, why? No, that's a tita. That's a, he hangs out in the street, and I can hang out with him. I was like, damn.
In the beginning, it was like, I know Pete. Let's go to Pete's house.
Right.
Pete, bring the cables because we're gonna do an outdoor party, and your sister's gonna fry some chicken, and we'll sell a plate of food for a dollar.
There are parties. They'd spin these classic jams.
Breaking was used to describe what was happening with the DJ as he was extending the break of a record that made people go off on the dance floor. Now, each DJ played different kind of breaks. Some people like just to play the breaks of conga. Some other breakers like horns, like bongo rock or Apache, dance to the drummer's beat. So according to your personality and the personality of a DJ and what kind of break he played is what kind of dancer was on the floor, and those were the kind of moves that were dictated. So the whole rocking culture, rocking the mic, rocking the floor, rocking the wall, but the terminology rock came from actual rock records and the breaks in rock records. The early b-boys in the 70s were dancing to rock records, especially the break like Big Beat.
Big Beat by Billy Squire.
Billy Squire.
Steve Miller.
Steve Miller and Aerosmith. The funkiest part of anything that's gonna make you dance is hip hop.
B-boying is arguably more popular now worldwide than it's ever been, right? I mean, there's events where 10,000-15,000
yes.
people more will
yes.
show up to the event.
Yes.
I mean,
it's grown.
So,
it definitely has. The competitive aspect of it has. And
yeah.
there's only a few of these gatherings, competitions that have really like exploded. You know, like Freestyle Session, Battle of the Year, BC1, Euro Battle. R16, IBE, so that's like seven that have like really like, and they're in different places of the planet. So I think that those things have really challenged and charged up the scene, especially the young dancers, to get to this level where they're like undeniably amazing.
They're like Olympic level athletes.
Exactly, and there is probably an Olympic thing coming up too. I've heard some rumbling.
I'm doing the DP.
Oh, is that right?
Right.
Oh.
You know, turntable.
Oh, okay. I learned something new every day.